Hey, hi, what's up? How you doing? And I am kind of early, which is nice, right? Because I'm normally late. So let you guys come in, roll on in here before I start talking. I got like mad sinus issues going on here. My eyes running, so if you see me crying, I don't know, I might be emotional, or it just might be my eye. I got one of them styes, like where you have like they actually say it's kind of similar to a whitehead in your up under your eyelid. It's kind of funky and crazy. But for those that are coming in that I am not seeing roll in, I do appreciate you guys coming in, and I thank you so much for tuning in to another episode of Fears Friday. All right, and I'm not started. I haven't started just yet, so I'm getting myself a part here. I have like 2 more minutes to go. Hopefully, Facebook might be nice today. I'm on I'm in Facebook jail. I can't share anything. I can only post, and they're taking my money to boost my posts and all that, but I can't share anything. I broke one of the rules in a group, and I found out yesterday by researching that if a group pulls one of your posts or anything or something like that, they red flag it as being spam. Steve, we still talking tomorrow, sir. But it's not that I'm under the weather or got the flu or anything. It's my allergies. Allergies are bothering me real bad. And I've been having a bad speech problem this week. As you guys can look, I mean, see, I'm kind of rough around the edges. My hair is growing back. I've been kind of tired. They killed me this week at work. And so, I should be back on cue tomorrow. Hello, Miss Scott. How are you? And for those that are coming in that I don't see, I would like to say hello. Please understand that let's see. What I was about to say. well, first let me say welcome to Fierce Friday, guys. It is 7 o'clock now. But this is a show for those and about those with MS. I really never explained that. And it is public. So anybody outside of having MS can view this. And the reason for that is we can bridge the gap in between those diagnosed and those that are not diagnosed. A warrior stated something on the I Can Be MS page, and they said that when they got when they got diagnosed, like way back when, they said only 800,000 people were diagnosed with MS in the whole world. And they're kind of saying the same thing she was stating. I haven't seen that. I've actually seen millions, where they've the statistics and the facts and the build up. Hey Theo, how you doing, sir? The information gathered stated that it was a couple of million people out there. If not close to a million that has been diagnosed. And why are we still not, why are we still blind to the world? Why is the disease still blind? Why is the disease still, in a secret organization in itself? But again, welcome guys that are coming in, those that are diagnosed with MS and those that are not. I appreciate your viewing. And if you could stand my roughness and continue watching the show, I totally appreciate it because there's going to be some information that I'm going to give out for those that do not know for this fierce summer that is coming up, which it should be a huge heat, exhausting, fatigue like summer. If you look at the fact that we had a heck of a winter, so if we don't have a hot summer, I personally will be glad because then maybe I can go to a beach or something. But I feel like it's gonna be hot as hell. Saying it in my country voice, it's gonna be hot as hell. So just what this episode about? What are you going to do to keep cool? So I am not sure if I am going to be allowed to have any guests on. And right when I said that, my phone started acting up. As long as I'm videoing, it is fine. But for me pressing buttons or anything, it's not going to allow me because right now my iPhone is my iPhone is having issues. And I'm waiting for that line to disappear. My speech is awful, man. It's killing me. It's funny though. It is making me laugh. Because I had an issue at work and me trying to talk to a customer. It was like so funny. And the fact that you can laugh at yourself is even better. Because this can be very depressing at times, especially when you're trying to get something important out and it's just not going right, and people looking at you like you're crazy. But for those again that are coming in, I totally appreciate you guys watching. And so summer, I don't have this anymore. I am going to try to see about getting it again, though. I might not be able to get it because it's probably a one-time thing. I'm not sure if any or how many of you all are established with the Multiple Sclerosis Foundation or MS Society. If you're not, if you don't have like a profile, please, by all means, either go to one or the other. It is best to go to both because they can provide accessories and assets, even when it comes down to assisting with bills and stuff. Trust me, I have used them before. It's a one-time thing when it comes down to bills. Electric or rent. Like if you're behind, there's something that they're assist with. So, that's beside what I'm about to talk about now. But, oh, and I forgot the MSAA, which is Multiple Sclerosis Association of America. I'm going to put the link in here. Give me one second. Put this link down here for you guys or anybody that's watching. This is where I got my vest from last year. They allow you to choose what type of cooling vest. you will want. And it comes with a little scarf, cooling scarf. And hey, Mario, and everybody that's tuning in. Again, you guys, sometimes I don't even see who's watching due to if you're not part of my friends list, it doesn't pop up and show me. And sometimes it doesn't even show me at all. So if you're sitting there and you wonder like, why he saying hello to me? He know me. It's not that. Is and then sometimes it could just be going through the feed really quick to where I can't see. And so that's why I periodically stop and I say hello to everybody that's watching and thank you for tuning in. And if you don't know, this episode has something to do about trying to stay out of the heat. And if you are going to be in the heat, you just might need to have on a Batman utility belt and maybe a vest or a Batman suit. Heck, if you can talk to Tony Stark, maybe he'll give you an Iron Man suit or a War Machine suit. For those who haven't gone out to see the movie, shame on you. I'm not going to spoil anything, but it is fantastic when it comes down to a comic geek. But yes, cooling products. That is the link that I just post. I'm going to also, after the live feed is over, I'm going to post it in the I'm gonna post it in the caption thing, 'cause once I'm able to share it, people are not going to be able to watch the comments. So I'm also going to have it there. So if you don't come across it in my comments, you're going to see it up there after the show. So also we have the foundation. The foundation, I got my vest from MSAA. Now, I just came across the foundation, seeing that they do vests as well. I did not know that. But they vests look cooler, man. They look stylish. Like you can sit up here and wear them with any type of outfit versus the MSAA. MSAA, it kind of remind you of you like going to war. So when you're wearing the vest, it's kind of look like you got on a vest that has like bullet packs and all this, and you got rations and all this stuff, and you're finna go outside to go to war, which you probably really are because with the heat and your immense war, you got that fatigue going on. But yeah, comes in khaki and black, maybe another color, I'm not sure, but that is the foundation's link to sign up to get a cooling vest. And please, somebody, watch out for me and let me know. Hey, man, your nose is your nose is running, your eyes running. You might want to get that, 'cause I don't want nobody sitting up here laughing and saying like, "Hey, I mean, he got that snot coming down his nose," and y'all ain't got a joke on me like that. You know what I'm saying? But so I just feel awful. But the show has to go on, right? Even though you might not feel good, sometimes you got to go to work. This is not work. This is enjoyment, because I get to spend time with you guys, people that I love, and people I feel that love me. So, yeah, that's that link. Where is my society? Society? Well, I think a lot of folks are more in tune with the MS society than anything. But let's see. My computer's running slow, and I'm like, everything is just messing up on me, man. I was like, hey, MS Society got scholarships. Oh, Lord. Jesus. I ain't know that. I need to talk to them about their scholarships there. All right, let's see. Cooling programs. I don't know if they got one. It comes up. MS Society cooling vests. Let's see what we got here. No. I think they're the same people. And I don't know. I don't think, you know what? I don't believe MS Society does the cooling vest. They don't have the cooling vest program, but let's see. Cool it, beat the heat. Strategies for easy heat related symptoms. Additional cooling products. Polar products. Other resources. Energy outreach. Hey guys, the people that I just seen pop through, how you doing? No, that's not what I wanted. Oh, I guess it is. Alright. Okay, so they don't do the vest themselves, but they direct you to if I'm looking at it correctly, they direct you to MSAA. And so I think that's what happened to me. But for anyone that is like, how can I say it? If you're having to like be located in one room due to mobility, and it's not a room that is vented very well, and so you don't get any cool air from your air conditioner, or you might just have one of those houses that has window units or anything like that, then the society is the group that you want to talk to. Talk to about, because they would do in a portable, matter of fact, they do either or, but I know for a fact that they do portable units for MS patients under $400. You either find it online, you have to find it yourself, and you give them the information, and then they will look at it, and it will see if it's feasible, if they think like, okay, hey, all right, that's great. And so they will go and order it for you, basically. I don't have mine. I got it in my marriage that I'm getting out of. So all that stuff is like out of my hand, and I'm not sure if I can get other, but I'm in a situation where I don't need a portable AC at the moment. This might be different. Probably go and talk to them about that, with it being hot and the fact that I do want to visit the beach before this summer out. I plan on visiting the beach, and I don't want to be out there for 5 minutes. You get what I'm saying? I don't know about you guys. So that's some information that I wanted to provide to you all. Does anyone else have any ideas or possible gadgets that we can look into that can assist with staying cool for this hot summer that we got coming up? And Miss Regina says, yes, the MS Society gave me an air conditioner, cooling vest, and you get it every 7 years. So after 7 years, so if like, not saying Miss Regina is wrong, but you still want to check into it. Every 7 years, she's basically saying that you can try to re-up on that if you're still dealing with the hardship of MS. So I didn't know that much. Now I know that financial assistance that changes. You can only do that once a year. So if you need that right now, that'd be something that you might want to check into. I think they do up to $500. You have to do either or. And see, the thing is, you can go to the MS Society and get assistance for your rent, and then go to the MS Foundation and get assistance with your light bill. So, you know, that's like, that's if you're having a problem. I'm not sure if any one of you guys are having that problem, but I know that sometimes we come across hardship when it comes down with financial. And stopping again, for those that are watching, diagnosed or not, I do appreciate you guys tuning in today. And today is all about heat and what we can do. And if anybody that's watching, kind of like Regina just stated, giving some information, the turnaround on when you can ask, if you've already asked again. And if you guys are watching this on YouTube, in the description area, you will see the links for the websites that I just provided. So, do we have anybody on that would like to try and come up and be a guest and talk about things that has helped them deal with the heat over the past couple of years with MS? I will most likely try to bring you up and see if you're able to talk. If we can't, then I do apologize, but I will be totally appreciative, and I think everybody else would be, to hear any other ideas outside of what I am speaking of. And there's nothing wrong going out, having some water. It doesn't have to be like just extremely cold, but you know, a little cool so that you can feel a little refreshed when it's going down. But I know a lot of us are outside people, and our vitamin D, if you haven't gotten it checked, that is such an important thing when it comes down to a MS patient. Mine's just regulated. Let me tell you exactly what, why I'm talking about that. Let's see. Okay. I didn't want that. What should your vitamin D level be? If I'm not mistaken, I think it's supposed to be like 50. I could be wrong. Let's see. The most accurate way to measure how your vitamin D is in your body is the blood test. Okay, a level of 20 milligrams is considered accurate for healthy people. All right, so I was wrong when I told somebody what mine was. So you go get your blood run, right? Tested or whatever, and they sit up here. And when they run it, ask them what your levels are. Even though they tell you that they are low, ask them what your levels are, because that is very important. Let's see. I'm trying to get a... Hello, guys that are coming in. I totally appreciate it. I'm trying to find a freaking your level is 51. I take one capsule vitamin D 5,000 units daily. And Monica, that's exactly where I'm at now. I was taking 50,000 units a week due to the fact that mines were like 5, 12-ish. It was in between 5 and 12. It was like, dude, but I couldn't go outside. And the sad thing about it is, me and another warrior was talking about this. How are we supposed to get vitamin D if we can't go outside? Because the sun is the source of natural vitamin D, and then you really can't count on whole milk to give you vitamin D anymore, because we as humans are always tampering with stuff, and vitamin D really ain't in there anymore. So it's hard to get your vitamin D if you're not doing supplements. And so that is a very important thing. If your levels are okay, you haven't had any problems with it, please, by all means, go and get some supplements. Like Monica and I am taking, let's see here. I can go. Yeah, you see my knee, right? Vitamin D. 5,000 units. And then I'm also taking a once a day thingamajig. You really don't know how important vitamins is until you get sick. I'm gonna be honest with you. You know, my mom back in the day used to try and give me vitamins. Actually, I was taking a lot of vitamins at the beginning of the time that I got diagnosed, but when my family used to be, what them coupon people call them, the aggressive coupon people, the coupon maniacs, or somebody coupons, and we used to get a lot of vitamins on sale and stuff, and man, yeah, good times, you can go in a grocery store, spend about $200-$300, and on the walk I paying $20. Good time. Extreme couponing. Look, see? It comes back. But yeah. I'm trying to find a little thing here. Oh, okay. Look. Here's a image for a scale, actually. Ooh. I don't like that. That's a link and it's very long, but it's an image. It's an image of the scale for your vitamin D. And basically, deficiency is below 50. Optimal is, that's what I thought. Optimal was between 50 and 70. And mine was always below 12. If it's past 70 or 100, you need to be treated for cancer and heart disease. And if you're past 100, it means it's extremely excessive. Not sure why your vitamin D would be so high. Not even sure what would make your vitamin D go that high. What would you have, unless you're just taking like extra. Everything, every vitamin you take has vitamin D in it, and you're just having a vitamin D overload. I guess I'm kind of glad that they cut me off on mine, because I was being prescribed the 50,000 unit a week. So, yeah, that's great. Okay, so for you guys that are just coming in, I totally appreciate you watching. This is an episode where we are talking about staying cool, and we're really on the subject of vitamin D at the moment, but staying cool for the upcoming hot summer. Monica, your vitamin D was 12 when you started. Yes, that's how mine was, and it can actually cause a lot of problems. So, but I'm going to actually repost these links as well for those that are coming in. You can always also go back to, once the show is over, to the actual physical post, the actual post, once it's done, I'm gonna put it in the description as well. Hey, Miss Annette. So that was the first one, and that one was the MSAA. Wait, hold on. I don't think I did it right. Oh yeah, see, it didn't come up like last time. That sucks. And no, that was the Multiple Sclerosis Foundation. No, that was the MSAA. I don't did these things and don't forgot what's what. Monica says, I have a mini fan on a table in every room, and I use ceiling fans along with her AC. And that's a good idea. You rarely seldom see houses with ceiling fans and in all the rooms, but I'm starting to see a couple of houses that have ceiling fans in all the rooms and the living room. Mainly those, at least those rooms. You are at least the den like area, the gaming room or family room or something like that. But yeah, they do have the portable table fans and USB fans, and so, and you know, I actually have to, we have to go and get the car checked because, geez, that's gonna be heck. Like, seriously. The heat is already, when you have a car closed and the windows up. That is the other link that I posted, guys, for a vest. And then I also provided the link for MS Society. And like I stated before, I'm going to, at the end of the show, put it in the description as well. What is it? Darn. What you call that? Acting crazy. All right. Give me one second, guys. Oh, see? There's that. I had to catch it. It's like killing me, man. It's either that running or my eye running. It's like my whole left side just running. I'm scared that my whole body finna. I'm scared my whole body finna run from it. And if you guys haven't noticed, oh, Miss Annette, you're asking me a question. How am I? Well, right now my eyes running, my nose running, and yeah, and I stated that. It's hard though, you know, even though you need a little, it's hard to go out there in that sun, man, with it beaming all on you and causing the spasms. And okay, like if I'm laying up here in the bed and it just so happened it was cool when I went to sleep, and let's say there's nobody here and it gets hot out there and the air conditioning should have been turned on at some point in time, and I'm in here and I'm up under the covers, I'm done for. TMI, Miss Scott. Really? But I'm just saying, y'all supposed to help me, man. Y'all watching me and stuff. Y'all just gonna be sitting up here and watching. You know, what if I don't notice? Because I do have a beard and stuff, and you know, I might just think it's my hair moving or something. Y'all just gonna laugh at me, right? Is that what it is, Miss Scott? But Yeah, I would lock up in the bed. I've had it done before to where sometimes I get paralyzed. If it gets too hot for me, my legs are locked up completely. And it takes a moment before I can get them freed. I have to like go through a lot. But hopefully I won't have to go through all of that. Oh, that gets on my nerves. I hate when folks' messenger, Facebook Messenger gets hacked, and they send out these lottery things or the government. Hey, have you heard of the government thing? Where you can get money for this and this and this and that, like they're that actual person trying to get your information. I can't stand that crap. Because then you send up there thinking that's that person, and then you have to figure out. Sometimes you have to ask questions because they intercept you sitting and saying, "Hey, is this really you?" They're gonna say, "Yeah." So you're gonna have to ask them particular questions, and that they might not know, in order for you to realize that that ain't that person. So, and let's see, Miss Monica says, well, Marta says him too. And Miss Monica is also stating that she gets weak and dizzy in her legs. Turn to jello. Mine don't turn to jello per se. They just like get real hard and I can't feel them. It's almost like I'm being paralyzed. And yeah, I hate that as well. And for those that are coming in, thank you guys for watching. I totally appreciate it. And I extended an invitation out to anyone that is watching that has any ideas or would like to just maybe give it an experience that they've gone through the hellish hot days that we're having or have had before, and what they did to possibly be a little triumphant through it, or heck, if it didn't go good for you, but it was a learning experience, feel free to let me know that you want to come up. Hit a request button or invite button, or like I say, let me know and I'll go ahead and click on it and let you in. Opinion, as the years go on, it is going to get hotter and hotter because we're making room for all the babies that are coming in. And I do apologize if the feed becomes interrupted. I have Mediacom. There's a cable company that's here that is garbage. Even though I got high speeds, it can be garbage, and so it might interrupt. But us cutting out the trees to make room for the babies and the bigger families that are coming now is just messing with Mother Nature and the works of life when it comes down to the world. And so I'm not a scientist or anything like that, but it makes sense if you think about it. Because we're not replanting anything. And we're just basically messing with this crazy weather. That was my little moment of being a weatherman. But I hope you guys really stay cool. I hope you take heed to the information that I just provided, and get registered with either all three of the organizations, or two of them, or at least one. And Monica says she's frozen washcloths and taken, she has frozen washcloths. And have taken them on the beach vacation to put on her neck, like the cooling cloth. And that is a great idea. I never thought about that. And to even help, would you have a cooler with ice in it to help? Or, don't know. I don't know how that would work. Would that work? Because then you got to think about it. It's going to be wet. So, yeah, interruptions are happening. I do apologize. I really think it's Facebook as well. Facebook doesn't like me. That's an ugly face. It froze me like that. Why? I gotta shave. I don't know. Are you guys able to hear me at the same time? Or am I just making little funky faces? I guess I'm gonna have to just get off. Not sure what's going on. Oh boy. Can y'all hear me at all? I'm trying to see if somebody's gonna say that they can hear me. Connection. Mother. And then this right here, you messing up. Well, I guess this means I need to stop my feed. I do a pa spinning window pausing up on me. My phone be sucking tonight. Sorry, gone. If you see it, love you.